Apple is killing a lot of Macs with the release of macOS Ventura this fall, and especially it's killing my beloved 2012 Mac Pro cheese grater. So macOS 13 Ventura looks like the final frontier for a lot of now unsupported Mac models that run macOS Monterey without any problems, because Apple changed a lot behind the curtains, and it all starts with the decision of Apple to discontinue the support, the official support for the Mac Pro 2013. This Mac Pro is officially supported until the end of macOS Monterey, but it will not be officially supported by Ventura. And the reason for Apple doing this is because of the very old CPU that this Mac Pro uses. It's an Intel Xeon, codename Ivy Bridge. The next generation of Intel CPUs, after the first generation Nehalem, the second generation Sandy Bridge, and then the third generation Ivy Bridge, which went into the Mac Pro from 2013, was the fourth generation of Intel Core CPUs that are called Haswell. These fourth generation Haswell CPUs have one distinct difference. Intel introduced the extension of a code set that is called AVX2. And as Apple now dumped the Mac Pro 2013, they discontinued the support for pre-Haswell CPUs, which means macOS Ventura will make use of the AVX2 code instruction set. So that means that the Mac Pro 2013 and older, especially my beloved cheese grater here, all have pre-Haswell CPUs. So they do not have the AVX2 instruction set, so they won't be able to run Ventura without big problems. But the problems doesn't stop with the Haswell CPU. The fifth generation Broadwell and the sixth generation Skylake have the Intel Iris or Intel Graphics HD integrated graphic unit. And as Apple officially doesn't support those CPUs either, they just deleted the graphic drivers of those integrated graphic units. If you're now thinking, okay, no problem for me, I have an AMD graphic chip, there is one more issue. Apple also deleted the graphic drivers for AMD GCN, that's Graphic Core Next, first, second, and third generation. So that leaves you with at least an AMD Radeon 400 or 500 series or newer that still have graphic drivers in macOS 13 Ventura. But now let's get into the detail which Mac models are affected. So you can check if your model you already use or you're planning to buy maybe is affected or might be able to run macOS Ventura. Let's start with the MacBook Pro 2017. This one is the last one officially supported by Apple. The one before, that's the 2016 MacBook Pro, and these are the series 13.1, 13.2, and 13.3. As you can see, have an Intel Iris graphic chip. And as we already saw, there are no graphic drivers anymore. So if the devs can reintegrate the graphic drivers again into OpenCore, there's a good chance that the 2016 MacBook Pro will be able to run macOS Ventura with OpenCore. Same goes for the 2015 MacBook Pro that are either the MacBook Pro 12.1 or 11.4 or 11.5. Also, all of you with the 2013 or 14 MacBook Pro, same situation, Intel Iris GPU, where we need the graphic drivers. So all guys with a MacBook Pro 11, 1, 2, or 3 should be safe. But the 2012 and 13 MacBook Pro, which is either MacBook Pro 10.1 or 10.2 or 9.1 and 9.2, they also have an Ivy Bridge CPU, which means pre-Haswell, no AVX2, very little chance that the devs can somehow emulate the AVX2 instruction set, so that I think all of these MacBook Pros and older will not be able to run macOS Ventura even with OpenCore. Talking about MacBook Air, the version from 2018 is the last officially supported version for macOS Ventura, and the version from 2015 to 17, that is MacBook Air 7.1 and 7.2, same problem as with the MacBook Pro, these have Intel HD graphics integrated in the Broadwell CPU, so we need the graphic drivers, and then there's a good chance for macOS Ventura to run. Same goes with the MacBook Air 6.1 and 6.2 from 2013 and 14, but the final frontier might be the 2012 MacBook Air, that is version 5.1 and 5.2, which has Intel Ivy Bridge CPU, no AVX2 instructions. This MacBook Air won't be able to run macOS Ventura. The regular MacBook 2017, last officially supported MacBook by Apple. The 2016 MacBook has Intel HD graphics, no graphic drivers, and so there is a chance to run macOS Ventura if the devs can make it. The 2015 MacBook, same problem here, and the final frontier here starts with the very old MacBook from 2009 and 10, that is MacBook 6 or 7. These MacBooks have an NVIDIA GeForce graphic card, no drivers at all, and they have a Core 2 Duo CPU, which doesn't even have an Intel AVX 1 point whatever instruction set. So there's absolutely no chance to run macOS Ventura on these old MacBooks. Let's talk about iMac. The 2017 iMac or iMac Pro are the last official supported iMacs for macOS Ventura. The 2015 iMac has an Intel HD graphic. Same as with the MacBooks, the graphic drivers are missing and the devs have to re-implement them to make a 2015 iMac run macOS Ventura. The 2014 iMac has an AMD Radeon graphic card, but unfortunately this one belongs to one of the graphic core next generations where the drivers have been also deleted. Same problem here, the devs have to re-implement the graphic drivers and then there is a good chance that macOS Ventura will work on this iMac. Same problem with the iMac from 2013, we need the graphic drivers, and the iMac from 2012 and 13, which is iMac 13.1 or 13.2, they do have an Intel Ivy Bridge CPU, so there is very little chance that they can make it to Ventura. And for completion, Mac Mini. The 2018 Mac Mini is officially supported by Apple, and the 2014 Mac Mini, that is the Mac Mini 7.1. This one is losing for Ventura, but as we get graphic drivers in the open core, there's a good chance that this one can run macOS Ventura. The 2012 Mac Mini already has an Ivy Bridge CPU, no AVX2 instructions, so very little chance to run macOS Ventura. So as a conclusion, Apple is making it more and more harder for unsupported Macs to run newer macOSs. Either they lose new instruction sets or they delete graphic drivers from unsupported models, and the devs are working on it. I see a good chance that they can make it, at least for the graphic drivers. I don't think that they can accomplish like an AVX2 emulator to get older CPUs running the new macOS Ventura, but we will see, maybe they surprise us. Right now, you find more detailed information in the links below the video in the description. And if you haven't yet, I would really appreciate if you subscribe my channel and click the bell for notification to get any more updates. Like, for instance, the warning about macOS 12.5 deleting Kepler graphic drivers. And many people wrote comments like, oh, if I would have known that earlier, I wouldn't have updated to macOS 12.5 with my unsupported Mac. Right now, I hope that this video helped you with your unsupported Mac. or when you are planning to buy a used Mac, for your decision if it's worth the money when you're planning to use macOS Ventura. Have a good day. See you soon. Bye bye.